Hello there folks, how are we all doing? Out for another trip in the woods. Can't get any better. Another day off, another wee play. So I have a wee mess around with pot holders when it comes to campfires and all that sort of things. So I'll show you in a bit more detail what I've actually done so far. I'm planning another one, slightly different style in a wee while as well. But at the moment I'm going to get some lunch cooked up and have a bit of scoff. But it's been good fun, just sort of having a wee play and everything. It's more something that I don't always have a tripod. Again, this sort of area, there doesn't seem to be much in the way of actually dead wood. Everything you sort of go towards, you think is dead, and then you actually find out it's attached to something. So it's still actually living. And I've never ever cut anything down. So it was always a case of actually just trying to struggle a wee bit. But what I'm going to do is I'll show you the actual one I've done just now. After lunch, I'll make the other one. And I might actually even put up a wee tripod one as well, see what that's actually like. Okay, so I'll get the fire started and get the sausages on. So on this, what I've done is very simplistic. I basically got a hook at the actual top and then cut the two parts together so that they will go back into each other. And then leading up to the top where you've got your Y and then you've got your actual pot hanger itself just there. So nice and simplistic. Let's see if it works. Thank you. thought I'd just lower it down. Basically just like that. Very cool. Go, we spot a lunch. I went and forgot to put my garlic, salt, pepper on. Rats. Okay, well, the pot hanger worked out really, really good. Just having some pine needle tea just now, so. Well impressed with that. So I'm going to have this and that, and then I'm going to maybe try and do the second one as well, just to sort of see which one I prefer. Probably going to take this back and actually put it in camp, back in Conton, because it does seem pretty good. But I'll just finish this off and then I'll move on to the next one. Okay, see you in a bit. We'll try this one. Success with this one, it would just basically be a case of sliding it up and down the actual stick itself. So, say for instance, I wanted it closer to the fire, just move it down. And that works, or alternatively, further away. As well. So again, sort of two sort of reasonably easy ways of actually having a pot hangers where you can actually adjust it as you're actually going at camp. So good fun making it. Again, something I haven't done before, so always try and push myself and try and learn something new. Things like don't forget to put your spice on your sausages. There's a valuable lesson for us. But no, been really good fun. So just going to tidy up camp a wee bit and head home. No, that was good. So that's the two there. So I said, with that one, it's just a case of cutting it down really smooth on both sides and then just cutting into the actual wood itself. And you can just adjust the height of the billy can. And then with that one there, it's really a case of two locations. So again, that's sort of butted into there. Or alternatively, you can have it sort of rested up at top, across the top. Both of them work really, really well. I'm really pleased. So I'll leave it down to you guys to decide which one you prefer. So thanks so much for watching. It's been just a huge amount of fun. I just love learning things. I love seeing things on a lot of the stuff I see on Instagram and YouTube, etc. as well. Then think, you know what, how do you do that? So go off out into the woods and actually do it. So really good fun, really enjoyed it. So hopefully you've watched it. If you have, please subscribe, and I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I've actually done videoing it. Again, just look behind me. Just look at it. An amazing place. An absolutely amazing place. But a big message out at the moment, from the point of view of things like mental health and everything. You know, it's a case of you don't make memories sat on your mobile phone. You make memories by getting out into the forest and actually experiencing things. So please get out there, enjoy yourself. Have as much fun as you possibly can, as long as you do it safely. But I've got one last task, rather disappointingly, before I actually go home. I'm going to go across to the van and actually get a poly bag and actually come across. There's been some campers actually over in the area, and as I've been wandering around, there's just litter absolutely everywhere. Can never get my head around it, can't ever figure it out. We've always had this ethos of leave no trace. Well, some people don't quite believe in that, quite obviously. But don't end it on a rant, but as I said, I'm just going to go and actually get a bag and just tidy up all this rubbish. Beer cans all over the place, bottles and everything. Just unbelievable. Just absolutely unbelievable. You've got to take care of this. I mean, we're sitting there saying how gorgeous this place actually is, and yet for people to just leave it like that and think that it's just going to disappear, it'll be there for decades. So I'll go and get a bag and get it all cleared up. But rant over. As I said, hopefully you've enjoyed the video, and we'll see you next time. Take care then. Bye-bye.